Assalamu alaikum, my dear student. How are you? I hope you are keeping fine by the grace of Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. After many days, we are meeting. So, welcome to my class. After many days we are meeting, so welcome to my class. Boys, in order to join online class, all students must keep their microphone mute, please. Today we are going to discuss about a very important topic. Are you ready, boys? Okay, let us discuss the topic. You know that before half yearly exam, some chapters including lessons have left. So we have to go through these lessons. Today we want to discuss about the life of Hazrat Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Now I will share the screen and we are going to the next slide. I am Abdul Hamid, lecturer, Islamic Studies. Learning outcomes. After completing this lesson, you will be described the identity. You will be able to describe the identity of Hazrat Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu and his contribution to the charity, sacrifice, and good governance. The next slide, the life of Hazrat Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu at a glance. At first, his identity. Identity of Hazrat Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu. First Khalifa of Islam. Hazrat Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu was the first Khalifa of Islam. He was the first Khalifa after the death of Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He was born in 573 AD in the time claim. There is a MCQ level question. When was Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu born? Hazrat Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu was born in 573 AD. What was the claim of Hazrat Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala? The time claim. His boyhood name was Abdullah and his real name was Abdullah. Abu Bakr is his nickname. His real name was Abdullah. Titles Siddiq and Atiq. He got two titles. Siddiq, that means truthful, and Atiq, that means old. His father's name was Usman. Nickname Abu Quhafa. Nickname of Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu's father was Abu Quhafa. Mother's name was Salma. The name of mother of Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu was Salma and nickname Ummul Khair. They accepted Islam at the hands of Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. All of them accepted Islam at the hands of Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He was the father of Ummul Mumineen Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha. Hazrat Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu was the father of Ummul Mumineen. Ummul Mumineen, that means mother of Mumineen, mother of believers. Ummul Mumineen means mother of believers. Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha. So he was the father-in-law of Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Hazrat Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu was the father-in-law. Its Bengali meaning is shoshur. Hazrat Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu was the father-in-law of Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the next slide, we are going to the next slide. Acceptance of Islam. Hazrat Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu was the first among men to accept Islam. He had deep faith in the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Hazrat Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu was the first man. He was the first man to accept Islam. Among men, he was the first to accept Islam. And he had deep faith. He had deep belief in the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he was the first believer among men in the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Character and qualities. Hazrat Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu is spotless. He is spotless. And he was brave, patient, prudent, and farsighted. Hazrat Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala was brave and patient, prudent, and farsighted. He was the only one to unhesitatingly believe the flight of Miraj of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He believed unhesitatingly the flight of Miraj of Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That is why he was given the title Siddiq, and that is the reason he was given the title of Siddiq. Siddiq means truthful, very, very truthful. And he got this title. He was very polite and gentle kind of person. He was very polite and gentle kind of person. The next slide. Character and qualities. The contribution of Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu in the service of Islam incomparable. His services and contribution for the welfare of Islam is incomparable. He gave away all that he had for Islam. He gave away all that he had for Islam, for well-being of Islam, for the welfare of Islam. He spent for building the Masjid-e-Nabawi, the house of Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Masjid-e-Nabawi means the house of Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. What does Masjid-e-Nabawi means? Masjid-e-Nabawi means the house of Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And he spent for the Tabuk expedition, for the Tabuk battle, for the Tabuk wire. Expedition means wire or battle. He purchased innumerable slaves, including Hazrat Bilal radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and set them free. He purchased innumerable, uncountable slaves, including Hazrat Bilal radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and set them free. Preaching Islam. During the Hajj, he used to visit various tents and invite the people to accept Islam. During Hajj, he used to visit various tents and invite the people to accept Islam. Many Sahabis, including the distinguished youth of the Quraysh tribe, Hazrat Jubair radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Abdurrahman ibn Auf radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Saad radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and Talha radiallahu ta'ala anhu accepted Islam. By his preaching, those Sahabis were Muslim by his preaching during the Hajj Mawsum. Next slide, Hijrat to Medina. Hazrat Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu was the companion of Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam at the time of Hijrat. That means Hazrat Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu was the companion of Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam at the time of Hijrat, or that means at the time of migration from Makkah to Medina. Hijrat means to migrate from Makkah to Medina. At the date of the one night, he responded to the call of Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam and both started for Medina. at the dead of our night, Hazrat Muhammad called him and he responded to the call and both started for Medina, for Hijrat, for migration from Makkah to Medina. You know that who migrated from Makkah to Medina are called Muhajir. Muhajir, that means who migrated from Makkah to Medina. And Ansar means those who gave shelter to the Muhajir. That means Ansar. On the way, they took shelter in the cave of a mountain named Thawr to save themselves from the enemy. On the way, they took shelter in the cave of a mountain. What was the mountain? Mountain was Thawr. Thawr mountain. The name of this mountain was Thawr. And saved themselves from the enemy. From there, they completed the hijrah to Medina later on. And from this place, that means in the cave of from cave of a mountain that name is Thawr. From these places, they completed the hijrah to Medina. Election, the next point and topic is election as a Khalifa. Hazrat Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu elected as the first Khalifa of the Muslim world on 8th June 632 AD. When was Hazrat Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu elected as the first Khalifa of the Muslim world? There is a knowledgeable question or MCQ level question. When was Hazrat Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu elected as the first Khalifa of the Muslim world? The answer is Hazrat Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu was elected as the first Khalifa of the Muslim world on 8th June 632 AD. At this time, and when he was elected as the first Khalifa of the Muslim world, in this time, some people made the claim to prophethood and some others refused to pay zakat and some gave up Islam. In this situation, Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu controlled all these anarchies with iron hand and established peace. He controlled all these anarchies with iron hand and established peace and tranquility. Hazrat Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu finally established peace by controlling it with his iron hand. The Battle of Yamama started in 633 AD. In this battle, many Hafiz and Qari became martyrs. When was the Battle of Yamama took place? The Battle of Yamama started or took place in 633 AD. This is a knowledgeable question or MCQ level question. At this time, Hazrat Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu instructed Zayd ibn Sabit radiallahu ta'ala anhu to collect and preserve the verses of the Holy Quran, which was scattered in many places of the state. In this time, Hazrat Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu gave instruction to Zayd ibn Sabit radiallahu ta'ala anhu collect and preserve the verses of the Holy Quran, which was scattered in many places of the state. Because you know that many Hafiz and Qari were martyred in the Battle of Yamama, which was started in 663 AD. Wafat or death of Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala. Wafat means death. Death of Hazrat Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala. Or Wafat of Hazrat Abu Bakr. What does Wafat mean? What does Wafat mean? Wafat means death. Hazrat Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala who died on the 23rd August 634 AD. At the age of 63 years old. He was buried in the room of Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha beside Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Medina. Hazrat Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu was buried in the room of Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha beside Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And there is some other discussion. When the battle of Yamama took place, in this battle many Hafiz and Qari became martyrs. In this time, he instructed Zayd ibn Sabit radiallahu ta'ala anhu to collect and preserve the verses of Holy Quran, which was scattered in the many places of the estate. Having been commanded, Zayd ibn Sabit radiallahu ta'ala anhu collected the verses of Quran written on bars of trees, bones and hides of animals, as well as on smooth stones. And the next slide. Homework. There is a homework for you. There is a homework for you. And that is a creative question. Question number one. Shazid Hussain regularly studies about the ideal lives of the great personalities of Islam. Shazid Hussain regularly studies about the ideal life of the great personalities of Islam. He recently learned of a great person who was the first among men to accept Islam. That person spoke sparingly but was patient, prudent, visionary. He was companion of Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam at the time of Hijrat in Medina. Here there are four types of question. Number one, knowledgeable question or knowledge level question, A. Number two, understandable question or thinking level question. Number C, application level question. And number D, R, skill level question. Number A, who was the first question? Who was the father of Ummul Mumineen, Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha? And that means write the name of the father of Hazrat Ummul Mumineen, Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha. And number two, who was the first among men to accept Islam? Explain. Who was the first among men to accept Islam? Explain. This is an understandable question. Or thinking level question. Number C, or third, which great man does Sajid Hussain study the life of as mentioned stimulus? Explain the qualities of that man in light of your textbook. Which great man does Sajid Hussain study the life of as mentioned stimulus? Explain the qualities, or which was the qualities of that man in the light of your textbook. Right. And the number four, or the D number question, that means high skilled question. This great man was elected as the first Khalifa of the Muslim world. Do you agree with this? Give your opinion. This great man was elected and selected as the first Khalifa of the Muslim world, Muslim region, Muslim territory. Are you agree with this opinion? Is okay, so give your opinion. What is your opinion? Write this opinion. This is a homework. Everybody will take the screenshot. Everybody, every student will take the screenshot. And you will write the homework at your home. And you will see it, show it in the next class. You will show it in the next class. Homework. Creative question, one creative question, and there are four types of sub question: knowledgeable question, understanding level question, application level question, and higher skill level question. Question and answer session. Have you any question, dear student? If you have any question, dear student, if you have any question,
sir, what is smoke list?
Please unmute yourself, then ask me. At first, unmute yourself.
Sir, what is the meaning of Atik? Can you tell it again?
What is the meaning of
Atik?
Atik means old, old, old. That by Bengali meaning is Puraton.
Old. Old. Sir, old. What is the meaning of?
What is the meaning of?
The meaning of meaning of smoke list.
One by one, one by one. I can hear you. One by one. Say.
What is the meaning of family tree?
I cannot understand. What is that?
What is the meaning of Qari?
Qari means who recite best the Al-Quran. One who recite best the Al-Quran. Qari means one who recite Al-Quran best.
Sir, what is the meaning of family trees?
Fam? What is the meaning of?
Oratory, sir. Oratory.
Oratory. That means fluent. Fluent. Oratory means fluent. Bagmi. In Bengali meaning, it means bagmi.
Now, what is the meaning of spokeless?
He spoke less. He spoke some. He spoke some. He spoke less. In Bengali meaning, it means alpo bhashi. Shalpo bhashi. He spoke less.
Sir. Who is yes. Zayd ibn Sabit radiyallahu ta'ala anhu?
Zayd ibn Sabit radiyallahu ta'ala anhu was the collector leader.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, what is the meaning of inhabitants?
Inhabitants? What is the meaning of? What is the meaning of?
Inhabitants.
Means, in Bengali meaning, it means odivasi, odivasi.
Sir, what is the meaning of iron hand?
Iron hand means in a straight hand. Straight hand. Straight hand.
Sir, what is the meaning of Sir, what is the meaning of dignified?
Dignified?
Yes, sir.
Say the sentence, full sentence. Say the full sentence. Prominent. Dignified, that means prominent. 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 Dignified. One by one. If you have any problem, one by one.
Sir, who is the first recipient of Islam? Sir, how can we explain this?
Who is that?
First acceptances of Islam. How can we explain it?
Explain it.
Yes, sir.
Mute Koren.
There is a problem in microphone. On the occasion, he went to Yemen. On business, returning to Makkah, he heard the that Hazrat Muhammad claimed himself as a prophet and was preaching Islam. He appeared before the Prophet and accepted Islam, reading Kalima Shahadat. This is the explanation, or this is the elaboration, and this is the explanation of how he accepted Islam. One more question.
Sir, I also have a question. It is said that he was the first one who accepted Islam.
Among men, sir, there were many people before
Hazrat Muhammad.
Yes. Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu was the first who accepted Islam among boys. And Hazrat Khadija radiallahu ta'ala anha was the first woman who accepted Islam. Clear?
Yes, sir. But sir, isn't there any person who accepted Islam before
yes.
Sir Muhammad?
Again, say.
Sir, I have a question.
Sir, there are many people who accepted Islam before the preaching of Hazrat Muhammad, sir.
Yes.
Sallallahu alaihi
wasallam. There are many, but the religion was taken by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That means Hazrat Islam. And by his preaching, the first man who accepted Islam was Hazrat Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala.
Okay. Sir,
Hazrat Abu Bakr radiallahu, who is the first person who have accepted Islam all over men and women?
All over men. That means
men and women.
That is the Hazrat Adam alayhi salam.
No, Adam is the first man who was the Muslim and believer. Adam alayhi salam was the but by the preaching of Hazrat Muhammad, one who accepted Islam first among men was Hazrat Abu Bakr. Perspective is others.
Oh, yes, sir.
Perspective is others.
Ji sir, thik bol.
Yes. Have you any question?
Yes, ma'am.
Boys, you know that you have a homework. Oh. You have a homework. You must.
Yes, sir.
You must prepare it properly in the next classes, and will show me that you have prepared it smoothly and correctly.
Sir, where we properly. Will
show? Sir, homework. Sir, homework.
You will show it on the screen.
Sir, I have a question.
Oh, yes.
Okay, sir.
Yes.
Sir, what is the meaning of Khalifa?
Khalifa means one who stands for others. One who stands for others. That means in Bengali meaning is Salafishikto. One who stands for others. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Hazrat Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala was the first Khalifa of the Muslim world. That means after the death of Hazrat Muhammad, he stand for Hazrat Muhammad.
Sir, is this mean leader?
Leader, okay. Leader, but it is the worldly meaning. World meaning is who stand for others.
So behalf on
an Islamic perspective and Islamic parlance. Ones who operate the state according to the rules of Quran and the Sunnah and Ijma and Qiyas. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Have you got another question?
What is the meaning of family trees?
What is the meaning of
family trees?
Family
trees.
It's spelling the word. Lekha.
Family trees banan ki. FAMILYTREES.
Where is this word?
Sir, in this lesson, sir, in the identity, in the identity.
Identity.
No, sir, no, sir, it is lesson 3, sir. Sir, it is lesson 3.
Lesson 3, character and qualities.
Sir, bhule bhule bhule, sir.
Character and qualities.
Sir, thanks, sir. Thank you, sir.
Lol.
Okay.
Sir, butchi, sir, butchi.
Salagin class in the sari kono kotha reply je tumi lol bolte paro.
ইসলাম ক্লাসে লল বলে
হ্যাঁ ইসলাম ক্লাসে তুমি লল বলতে পারো তো ই বলা তো কোনো কথা রিপ্লাই দিয়ে তুমি লল বলতে পারো
সো আই
সি হ্যাজ স্যার কি আছে ভাই
দা ক্লাস ইজ আল্লাহ হাফেজ স্টে হোম অনেক খারাপ স্টে সেফ গিভেন অনলি ওয়ান অলমাইটি আল্লাহ
কই দেখলাম জি
আল্লাহ স্যার
আসসালামু
আলাইকুম
স্যার ওয়ালাইকুম স্যার
বাড়ির বাইরে বের হয়ে
না